Hello, hey, it's Chris here. Last week, Apple presented a bunch of new updates for their iOS, iPadOS, watchOS, and macOS platforms in their annual WWDC presentation. Now, after that, they did another presentation for developers called the Platform State of the Union, where they shared a lot of updates for Xcode, Swift, SwiftUI, and new APIs for developers. Now, in this video, I'm not going to go through all of those things because I wrote them all up in a blog post anyways, link in the description. But what I do want to share with you are the three big themes that jumped out at me as I was watching these presentations and what I think it'll mean for you and your app development in the near future. Okay, so theme number one, Apple announced that you can have widgets and glanceable information right on the lock screen. Not only that, these widgets can display live data, such as for sports games or workouts or the progress of your rideshare even. They also announced a new app intents framework that your app can implement so that your app's functionality can be surfaced at the OS level and be exposed to features like Siri,
Hello.
Shortcuts app, Spotlight search, and so on. Now to me, all of this points to an app experience that is freed from the traditional sense of the user having to launch your app in order to use it. With widgets, the user can look at your app's data on the lock screen or the home screen. And with App Intents, the user can use your app's functionality through Siri and shortcuts and more. So I think the fact of the matter is, if you're not leveraging these frameworks and you're still relying on the user to manually launch your app in order to use it, I think you're going to be missing out big time, especially with how many apps are on a user's device these days. Okay, on to the next big theme. Apple also announced a lot of new improvements to SwiftUI, including native chart components, better management of app navigation, more flexibility and options for laying out your components in your views, and also easier ways to integrate SwiftUI into an existing UI kit project. Now, some of these things have been a thorn in our side for a long time now, such as with app navigation in SwiftUI. We were limited to kind of the standard basic types of app navigation, and if we wanted to do anything more complex, it was a real struggle. But what these announcements show me, and really there's no surprise here, is that Apple is really trying to get us all to join the SwiftUI bus, so to say. This is the direction that they're headed in, and I've always said in the past, don't fight against it, just go with the flow. SwiftUI is maturing, it's gonna get to that point where you want to start your project in SwiftUI. Now let's face it, UIKit still provides way more control and flexibility in terms of app development, but I still feel that for someone who is new and someone who is just picking up app development, SwiftUI is still the way to go because it's a much more joyful learning experience and you're less likely to give up. And really, when you're starting out and starting to learn, that is the most important thing, not giving up, just getting past that hump, getting to the point where you want to do it more and you see progress, right? So SwiftUI is perfect for that. So if you're an existing app developer, what does this mean for you? Well, I think that you should consider when you're starting a new project, basing it on SwiftUI and integrating UIKit into it. That way, your project will be more future-proof as Apple continues to refine and improve SwiftUI. So to recap, theme number two is Apple pushing the migration and adoption of SwiftUI. Okay, now onto the third big theme, which is cross-platform shared code base. I'm not talking about cross-platform such as Android versus iOS, but more so across Apple's other platforms like iPad, Mac, and on the watch, and even Apple TV. In the two presentations, Apple also announced improvements to Swift and the Xcode tooling to make it easier for us to build apps that work seamlessly across all their platforms. In their presentation, they showed how easy it was to add an additional target for another platform in your Xcode project. There are also improvements to SwiftUI Preview to allow you to easily see how your UI would look on a different platform and also variations in that platform, such as for your watch where you have different color sets that you can cycle through and things like that. SwiftUI already adapts nicely to different screen sizes, and now with additional options and flexibility with new types of layout components that we can use, it makes it even easier to lay out your UI for different screen sizes. And if you need to, you can write blocks of code and condition statements where certain pieces of code or functionality will only run on specific platforms. Now I can see why Apple wants us to build apps on all of their platforms, as I'm sure the non-iOS app stores probably need a boost, but as developers, we have to consider the impact on launching an app on multiple platforms as well. Yes, you can get more eyeballs for your app. However, that also means more complexity when it comes to support, right? Imagine getting bug reports on all the platforms and not just on one platform. If you're a single person team or a small team with limited resources, I would carefully consider which platforms you launch your app to. Focus on the platforms that make the most sense for the use case of your app. In some cases, for example, a food tracker app, perhaps having an Apple Watch experience, really adds to the general use case of tracking food, makes it a lot more convenient for people, right? So in that case, it might make sense to build an Apple Watch experience in addition to the iOS core app. So the third big theme is Apple pushing multi-platform. So these were the three biggest themes that jumped out to me as I watched the WWDC presentation and the platform State of the Union. Was it the same for you, or did you notice something else? Let me know in the comments below what announcement you're the most excited about. And by the way, if you want to read the notes that I wrote up on both of these presentations, check out my blog article right over there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.